newbies out there, welcome. I create content here on motherhood, lifestyle, beauty, and I also do some vlogging. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button now if that sounds like something you like. And don't forget to turn on your notification bell so you never miss an upload. Potty training and some things that we've learned along the way, what's worked for us, and hey, may work for you as well. Now, before we get started, I just want to say to all my fellow moms out there, every child is different and every child catches on to potty training at their own time and when they're ready. So it's super important to look for the signs, and if you give it a try and it doesn't work, please don't beat yourself up about it. There's nothing wrong with you. There's nothing wrong with your child. They just may not be ready yet. So in other words, if mom guilt starts to creep up on you, tell her to get her ass out of here because nobody invited her to this party. Now that we've got that out the way, let's go ahead and jump into the video. So the first thing we did with our daughter Ava is when she was about roughly 18 months old, we went ahead and brought the potty into the bathroom and just started getting her a little familiar and comfortable with sitting on the pot. Her godmom had gotten her a potty for her birthday and we left it in the box for a while, but when we started noticing that she was noticing certain things, like she'd come into the bathroom with me sometimes and she'd say, "Oh, mommy's pee-peeing." Like, I'm like, okay, she's starting to realize some things. So basically, whenever I would go into the bathroom, I bring Ava in there with me and kind of just have her copy what I was doing and explaining to her, mommy was going to the potty, mommy was going pee pee or poo poo, and just, you know, so she could start to understand what was going on. At this point, she still was wearing her diaper. I didn't even take the diaper off of her when she sat on the pot. It was more so just to get her comfortable with it. So we did that for a little while, and then slowly transitioned into taking the diapers off of her when she would sit on the pot. Most of the time, nothing happened, but when she did actually go on the pot, we made it a big party. We praised her, clapped our hands, and made her super excited. You almost have to get overly excited that they just did this amazing thing, and it made her excited as well. So she kind of started to catch on a little bit that way. So after that, small changes started to happen. Ava started noticing things and started really understanding what was going on. There's a few times that her dad would be in the bathroom with the door shut and she'd walk by and say, "Look, mommy, daddy's pee-peeing in the potty." So, you know, she just started to associate that when someone was in the restroom that they were using the pot, and that was a great thing. She started pulling off her diaper. She would go longer times with being dry, and she would sometimes wake up from nap time dry, or even from bedtime, she wouldn't have a full diaper like she would in the past. So I just started noticing that certain things were starting to change, and I'm like, okay, I think it's time to kind of kick this potty training thing up a notch. By this time, she had literally just turned 2 years old, so we were like, all right, let's just go ahead and do it. So then Ava got her first pair of panties, which my sister actually purchased for her. Ava's completely obsessed with Minnie Mouse, so she got her a pair of Minnie Mouse panties, and when she saw that, she was uber excited to put them on. I told Ava, we don't want to make Minnie Mouse sad, so we have to keep our panties dry. And then I would say, no wet panties. So that kind of turned into like our little saying or our chant. I would say, no wet panties, every time she put a new pair on, and then she would repeat, no wet panties. As you can imagine, it did not happen that easily. The first few days, boy, did we go through some panties. It was like having an infant all over again, the amount of clothes that had to be washed because she was, you know, having accidents in them. But we wanted her to feel the wetness, you know, that really, really helped. And she would come to me. After a while, she started realizing what was going on, and she would come to me and say, "Oh no, mommy, I'm wet." So I would just explain to her again, you know, "Oh no, you wet your panty. Do you have to sit on the pot when your pee-pee goes in the pot?" And I would have her sit down for a little bit. And sometimes she would go some more. And then other times nothing would happen. But it was more so just explaining it to her so that she could understand what was going on. So eventually she started to really recognize when she had the urge to go to the bathroom rather than after it had already happened. She'd come grab me or her dad and let us know that she had to go pee pee, and then we would take her to the bathroom, sit her on the pot, and if something happened, if she actually did go pee pee in her potty, we would reward her with some type of a treat. Now, Ava can actually go a whole day with wearing her panties. She'll usually have like maybe one accident and we'll have to change her panties. But I still think that's an amazing thing, because throughout this potty training process, your child is gonna have accidents. They're not gonna just catch it like that and then they don't ever pee on themselves again. So this is good. And you just have to constantly ask them, do you have to go to the potty? Do you have to go to the potty? Let's go. And just take them to the pot, have them sit down on it. And if something happens, great. So the only time that she doesn't wear her panties is usually during nap time and bedtime. But recently for her naps, I've been leaving panties on her and we just go to the restroom before she goes to sleep and when she wakes up. And then last night was her first time ever wearing panties for bedtime. And she actually woke up with them completely dry. So I was super, super satisfied with that. I think I was more nervous about her not wearing a diaper for bedtime than she was. So we'll give it another try tonight and hopefully it's a success. All right guys, so now that you've kind of gotten the backstory, let's go through a quick little recap on how we got to this point and what you can do to get your child to this point. First thing you want to do is obviously go ahead and get your child a potty and allow them to sit on the pot at their leisure just to start getting familiar with the pot and getting comfortable with sitting on the pot. Take them into the bathroom with you and let them copy what you're doing and kind of explain to them what's happening. When they do go pee pee in the potty, make sure to get extremely excited and make your child feel like a rock star. Watch for cues and signs that your child's ready to kick it up a notch and go ahead to the next phase of potty training. Get your child a pair of panties or underwear that are in their favorite character, or allow them to pick them out themselves. Explain to your child that pee pee goes in the potty, not in your underpants. Sporadically take your child to the bathroom and have them sit down on the potty. I would take Ava about once every hour, but this time may be different for everyone. Reward your child with a treat whenever they do go pee pee on the potty. This can be a jelly bean, a cookie, blueberries if you want to keep it healthy. If you don't really like the food idea, you can get you a book of stickers or just something that would make your child excited. Always take your child to the potty immediately when they wake up from bedtime, before and after nap times, before bedtimes, and before leaving the house. Now this next tip, in my opinion, is one of the most important ones, and that is get everyone involved. It wasn't just myself and Ricky working on this with Ava. Her grandparents were involved and her aunts too. You've heard the saying, it takes a village to raise a child. Well, this isn't any different. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it to be helpful during you and your little one's potty training journey. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and comment below. And it is not too late to go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.